Get it! every struggle, every situation. We lift you above, we lift you above. Go and extend your hands toward heaven right now. I know the enemy tries to attack us and tries to weigh us down, gives us reasons not to come to the house of God, gives us excuses to walk in with an attitude, gives us reasons to want to be somewhere else in our mind. But right now, we're just going to focus on him. We're going to fight back the enemy right now with our worship, with our praise, with our prayer. Devil, you have no authority in God's house or in God's children. Father God, we don't care what the situation is. We don't care what the hurdles are, Father God. We don't care how the day went or the week went, Father God. We are going to be in your house and we're going to worship you and we're going to give you all of our heart, all of our praise, all of our worship tonight, Father God. We lift you up in this place.
You got it. How could I express all my gratitude? I could sing these songs as I often do. But every summer
Yeah.
mine much, but I've nothing else before my King, except for a heart singing hallelujah, hallelujah.
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Come on, we serve a mighty God. Give him a shout. Father God, we just pray for our family members on the prayer wall today, Father. Those, Father God, that we're standing in the gap, Father, for, Father God, believing, Lord, believing that you have a plan for them, Father God, believing that it is not finished, that the situation is not final right now, Lord. And we just praise you and we thank you ahead of time, Father God. We come to you, Father God, in gratitude, O Lord, for what you're going to do within our loved ones' lives, Father God. And we stand on your word, Father God, believing and not wavering, Father God, believing and not doubting, O Lord, believing, Father God, that your word is yea and amen, Father God, that you are still a God of miracles, O God. Lord, we thank you, Jesus. Lord, we thank you, Lord. Shout of thanks right now in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Amen, church. Well, we're glad to have you. Welcome out to Living Word Christian Center. You may be seated for today's announcements.
We're so glad you came to worship with us today. On behalf of Pastors Edgy and Sonia Gallegos, welcome to Living Word Inland Empire. We are so excited to announce that we now have classes available for ages 1 to 4 years old. If your little ones are around this age, be sure to sign them in so they can join us in Sunday school. We had an amazing turnout at our Live Youth Night held on campus. Attention all youth, be sure to mark your calendars because our next youth night will be held Friday, March 11th at 7 p.m. Be sure to mark your calendars for Friday, March 11th at 7 p.m. for our next Women's Bible Study located in the cafe. We can't wait to see you there. Mark your calendars, men. Join Living Word Chino Hills for their Men of Action Men's Discipleship held February 25th at 7 p.m. We have a guest speaker on February 27th. Don't forget to invite somebody out because you guys don't want to miss it. Get ready for our men's discipleship held March 19th at 10 a.m., where you guys will be having a barbecue, discipleship, games, and fellowship. If you would like to be a part of this men's discipleship, we encourage you to register today by checking out our Facebook or Instagram. Be sure to join us after service in the cafe for food and fellowship. We invite you to come pray, believe, and expect with us every Monday night at 7 p.m. for our Monday night prayer night. We can't wait to see you there. We would love for you to stay connected with us here at Living Word. The ways you can do so is by liking our Facebook page, subscribing to our YouTube channel, or following us on Instagram. And if you happen to miss a service, don't worry, we've got you covered. You can listen now by checking out our podcast. Now it's time for tithes and offering. Let's open our hearts and get ready to give.
Give the Lord a good clap offering today, amen. Amen. As the ushers come forward, if you need an envelope, just lift up your hands. As we turn to Hebrews chapter 11. Hebrews chapter 11, verse 1. Amen. The Word of God says right here, now faith is the assurance of things hoped for. Amen. How many guys hope for a lot of things right now? Amen. How many guys have hope for the things that you've been praying for? Amen. Now the word assurance means I'm going to have confidence in the things that God is going to do. So if you believe in God, it's saying that the faith that you have, the assurance that God is going to do it, and that's by faith. God looks at our heart and he says, look, are they doing what I called them to do? Now, if you do what God has called you to do, you have the assurance. You have the confidence. And it says right there, the word assurance is actually a declaration. That I have faith that the declaration of the things hoped for, that the convictions of things have not seen. And that's why when we give in faith. We say, look at God, I know I don't see you, but I know you're there. I don't see you, but I know you have my back. Amen. I don't see you, but I know you're going to take care of all the things. Amen. Because that's the God that we serve. In everything that we do, we got to do it in faith. It says that we can't please God unless we do it by faith. Amen. So as we give today, when we give, we got to remember we're doing it in faith because we know that God is going to take over. The quicker we do it, is the quicker God can move. The longer you take, the longer you tie up God's hands. Amen? So as we believe together, if you don't have, it's not going to get you to heaven. But we'll just pray for you that you may have something. Amen? That you may have a job so that you could be a testimony in the future. Amen? Because we're believing with you. We're having faith for you that you're going to get those jobs, that you're going to get the finances you need, that you're going to get the things that you have been praying for. Amen? So as we lift our hands, as we just pray right now, Father God, we just bless your holy name right now, Father. For we don't come with a laundry list of what we need, but we just know that you're there for us. We just know that you've always been there for us, that we thank you, Lord, for everything that you're doing in our lives. And Lord, for those that don't have, that you may give to them, Father God, so that they may be a testimony in your kingdom, just like we are, Father. As we just bless your holy name, we trust in you with everything. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Come on, let's give the Lord a good clap offering. A good clap offering to Pastor Rudy. Amen. Come on, Pastor Rudy. Amen. You may be seated. Amen. Amen. You guys ready for a good word? How many guys ready for a good word? Amen. Amen. Pastor Rudy, he has a lot in him. There's a lot of wisdom. Lots of wisdom.
Thank you. Praise the Lord. It's good to be in the house of the Lord. Amen. Come on, let's give the Lord a clap offering. Let's praise God. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. You got to get fired up. Hallelujah. You seen the Super Bowl? You probably were saying, come on, go Rams. This is the Rams. I'll tell you what, this is God's house. Amen. If I say whose house is this, you say this is God's house. Now whose house is this? Come on, let's give them a shout of praise. Hallelujah. Come on, you can't be dead. This is living word. If you got the word, you're alive. Hallelujah. Well, I want to slow it down a little bit. Because I get excited. Praise the Lord. I just, you know, the worship team is awesome. You know, the worship team is awesome. Come on, let's give them a hand. Amen. They're awesome. I thank my pastor, Edgie, and his wife, Sonia, and this congregation for helping me and my wife and welcoming this place. This is a powerful church. This is a church on fire. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. You need to start jumping. Amen. Start saying amen. Hallelujah. You know what? I remember when I could jump and everything. You know what? I got a bad knee and now, but you can do it. Amen. Got to get fired up. You were watching the Rams today, and they had a parade, and all the people are out there. Amen. You know, we need to do something for God. We need to be on the streets. Amen. We need to tell your neighbor, your father, your mother, your son about Jesus. Amen. I'm going to follow the lines of Pastor Edgie, what he's preaching on. Amen. And that's walking in faith. Amen. Hallelujah. I titled this message the last time I didn't have a title. Who are you walking with? Who are you walking with? Hebrews 11:6. Hebrews 11:6. It says, but without faith, it is impossible to please him. For he who comes to God must believe that he is and that he is a rewarder. Say rewarder. Say it loud, rewarder. Of those who diligently seek him. Precious Father, Lord, I give you all the glory, all the honor. I thank you, Lord, for all the people that are here, Lord. I pray that you'll speak to them individually and that you've got a word for them, God, that they can live by faith. And I pray, Father God, that all the doubt will leave in the name of Jesus. And devil, you're a liar, and the blood of Jesus sets us free. I thank you, I praise you, and I give you all the glory and all the honor this evening. And everybody said, amen. Hallelujah. Walking in faith. Our faith in God grows as we have fellowship with God. If you have faith this evening, amen, I'll tell you what, your fellowship with God, it'll grow and grow as you're in the Word of God, as God is moving in your life. God will speak to you. The way he's going to speak to you is through his Word, amen. And I'll tell you what, his Word is fire. His Word is yes and amen. I'll tell you, you need to get excited because God saved you. God moved in your life. You were dead in your sins, but by faith, you're saved now. Hallelujah. Faith means we cannot see the outcome. We are not sure what lies ahead, but we're not sure what the future holds. But we know who holds the future, and his name is God, Jesus Christ, amen, the Holy Ghost. If you have the Holy Ghost, I'll tell you what, he'll show you the future. You see, I remember catching a plane for 17 hours in the plane going to Chile. I didn't know what was going to happen over there. I didn't know what I was going to do over there, but God knew. And I went by faith. Went by faith. And when I land there, there was nobody to greet me. And I said, well, where's the five-star hotel? They took me to this hotel. We had fleas in that hotel. I said, this is what I came to. And then I said, where's the church? He said, you got to start the church. I started preaching on the street corner, amen. People began to get saved. God opened the doors, amen. I got rented a house, amen. How many know that God will do it if you do it by faith, amen, not knowing where you're going? People say, well, I want to go over here. Well, yeah, because you bought a house there. Come on now. Hallelujah. Abraham left by faith, not knowing where he was going. Hallelujah. You see, God is calling preachers. God is calling you. God is calling men and women of faith, amen, that's going to do something powerful for God. Don't be afraid. When in the world you weren't afraid. Hallelujah. All of a sudden we get saved and we get afraid. I'll tell you what, God is powerful. God will use you. God will do something great in your life. But you got to say, you know what, God, send me. Help me. Help my unbelief believe. Hallelujah. You see the example of the Son of God. How many know that Jesus is our example? Jesus is a great example. How many know that we live by examples? We have pastor here and his wife, amen. They're examples. I could see, how God has blessed, amen. Why? Because of faith. Hallelujah. I look at the men's home and the women's home. I'll tell you what, by faith, they're doing things for God, amen. They're going forward. They're on fire for God, hallelujah. I'll tell you what, this church is unstoppable. The devil wants to stop the church, but we got to keep on going. Hallelujah. Exampleship. Very important, church. Very important. Exampleship. Hebrews 12:2. If you're a good disciple, when the preacher's preaching, you write down the verse. Amen. Don't ask him, wait, where did he say? Pay attention. Hallelujah. Looking unto Jesus, the author, the finisher of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, despising the shame, and is set down at the right hand of the throne of God. Hallelujah. That is powerful, church. That's who we got to look to. We got to look to Jesus. We got to look to the cross. Where there was a shedding of blood, amen. I'll tell you, without the shedding of blood, there's no forgiveness of sin. But there was a man called Jesus. He shed his blood for you. He shed his blood for me, that we may be set free. Hallelujah. You don't have to be in bondage no more. Whoever the Son set free is free indeed. Can you give him some praise? You got to praise the Lord. You got to get excited. Hallelujah. He endured so you can endure. Jesus endured so you can endure. You can make it. And not by the skin of your teeth either. You can do it. Say, I can do it. Tell your neighbor, I can do this. When I was from the hood, I said, I could do this. Que se haga. There was no fear. Can somebody say, Jesus? You got the Holy Ghost. You got all heaven backing you up. You can do this. You can walk by faith. Praise the Lord. Look at Jesus. He is the author. He is originator. People say, well, I did this. I originated. No, he's the originator. You're a copycat. Hallelujah. See, he's the originator. He's the finisher of our faith. Hallelujah. That's why, you know what, it's all been all done. It all happened. That's why he said it's finished when he looked to the cross. It's done already. All we got to do is walk through it. Amen. You see, the Jewish believers were getting tired and wanted to give up. How many of you wanted to give up? You wanted to give up. I'll tell you what, but Paul answered them. Paul told them in the book of Hebrews. Hallelujah. Encourage them to keep on moving forward in their Christian lives. How many know we got to keep on moving forward? We got to keep on going. We can't stop. We got to get up, dust yourself off. You never been in a fight? I've been in a lot of fights, lost all of the fights, but I still got up. Amen. How many know that we're in a war? We're in a fight, but you can't see the enemy. Hallelujah. We don't fight against flesh and blood, against each other, but a spiritual places. They're high in high places. That's why we got to have the whole armor of God on. Hallelujah. Not half armor, the whole armor of God. We're in a fight, church. But don't quit. Encourage. How many know we need to encourage each other? And if you can't encourage nobody, ask God to encourage you. Ask God. That's why it's very important that we read the Bible. We got to read this. Because this will encourage you every day to make it. Hallelujah. We can get our lives. We can get our lives encouraged from the word of God. It was looking unto Jesus that we were saved. We looked to Jesus. I remember when I was 20 years old and the preacher walked in and I was laying in the hospital. How many know that when you're down and out, you'll want God? Amen. I don't want another drink. I didn't want another woman. I don't want another dope. I didn't want another party. I wanted Jesus. Hallelujah. When you have only 5 days to live, I'll tell you, you know what? I want Jesus. Give me a quebrada, Jesus, and I'll serve you. Amen. You never faced anything? I've been to the doctor just lately. Oh, bad news. I said, hey, I got some good news. Jesus is a healer. Hallelujah. Jesus, hallelujah, is on my side. If Jesus be for you, who could be against you? See, it's easy for us to pray for other people, but how about praying for yourself? You're healed in the name of Jesus. Come on now. We want everybody to pray for us. Why don't you pray for yourself? Hallelujah. Whose report will you believe? I shall believe the report of the Lord. Amen. Come on now. If you're going to clap, let's clap. Hallelujah. Praise God. How many know the devil will give you a bad report? How many know the people will give you a bad report? How many know people will put you down? But how many know the word of God will pick you up? The word of God will pick you up. That's what happened to Saul. He looked to the people. King Saul, he looked to the people. Hallelujah. He wanted to know how the people felt. No, you know, you got to look to God. But when he was small in God's eyes, he always looked to God. Walking by faith. To look means to trust. How many know we got to trust? We got to trust God. That God's going to do what he says he's going to do in his word. How many know that we got to hold him to his word? We got to open up this Bible and say, okay, God, you said to look unto you. And I'm looking to you. How many know that we're not perfect? But I'll tell you what, that doesn't give us an excuse. We can look to God and God will help us. To trust. Hebrews 2:13. Hallelujah. I will put my trust in him. I will put my trust in him. How many are going to put your trust in God? How many know you put your trust in a woman and she burns you? Come on, brother. That's why you're in the home. Hello. Hello, sister. Oh, just the pastor, huh? Hallelujah. Walking in faith, looking unto Jesus describes an attitude of faith. How's our attitude tonight? What's our attitude towards God? What's our attitude towards faith? Oh, you know what, man? I don't really believe in. Hallelujah. You'll believe it one day. Like I told you, when I was 20 years old, laying in General Hospital in L.A., in Boyle Heights. I said, you know what? I believe. How many know when you're down, you'll believe? There's a lot of people, young people. I talk to a lot of people, and you know what? They're depressed. They take medication. They go see the shrink. Why don't you, you know what? It's free. Read the word. Hallelujah. Read the word. Hallelujah. The word will encourage you. The word will get you out of depression. Hallelujah. And a suicidal mind. Hallelujah. You'll stop hearing voices. Hallelujah. What's our attitude towards faith? How's your attitude? Is he a perfect example to follow? Is Jesus Christ. Following Jesus. Looking unto Jesus, reading your word every day. We're in the one-year Bible, hallelujah. Right here, you know, in the church, Pastor Edgy has put it up. You got to read your Bible every day. And I'll tell you what, you'll get excited. I'll tell you what, no matter what condition you're in, you'll have faith in the word of God because God will touch you. God will revive you. I'll tell you what, God will do anything but fail tonight. Hallelujah. He endured the cross. What cross do you got to endure? Every day you got to pick up your cross. You got to pick up that word. You got to pick up this word right here and read it. And read it. It's hard work walking for the Lord in this world today. The world's corrupt. How do you know? Shaw was corrupt. How many know that God will clean your mind up? God will help you. God will help me. Hallelujah. God will help an individual that's down and out. God will help any woman that's down and out. I'll tell you, God will pick you up, but you got to look unto him. We look to other people. We look to other people, and they just look at us. Really? Are you for real? And you're a Christian. You should read your word. Hallelujah. He endured it. It was Jesus' faith. It was Jesus' faith that enabled him to endure. It was his faith that, you know, in his father, that his father was going to take care of business for him. I'll tell you what, we look to Jesus, and we got to know that he's going to take care of business, and he's got your back. You wear that shirt, that T-shirt, he's got my back. Amen? He endured. How many know if he endured? You can endure because he's in your heart. He's inside of you. Hallelujah. He's inside of you. I can do this, God. I can do that. You can strengthen me. The joy of the Lord is my strength. I'm not happy, but the joy, hallelujah. When you're going through, you're not happy, but you have the joy of God. You're going to make it. Faith will enable you and I to endure. We can endure it. When all people are talking about you, when all hell's breaking loose, huh? When people turn against you, you say, I can endure this. I'm going to pick up my cross and I'm going to go forward. He kept the eye of faith on the joy that was set before him, that he would complete the Father's will. How many know that he wanted to please his father? How many want to please your father? I want to please my father in heaven. Hallelujah. I don't have an earthly father no more. He passed away, but I got a heavenly father. Maybe you don't have a father, but you got a heavenly father. And I'll tell you what, don't you want to please him and do his will? I want to do what God called me to do. Like Peter, when we take our eyes off of faith, off the Savior, off Jesus, we start sinking. How many know we can walk on water? Probably in the bathtub, hallelujah. But how many know when we take our eyes off of Jesus, we start going down? That's why we got to be in church. That's why we got to be in prayer. That's why we got to be in the Word, amen, and not take our eyes off of Jesus and start sinking, amen. How are you walking tonight? Hebrews 11:6, by faith, Enoch was taken away so that he did not see death, and he was not found because God had taken him. Before he was taken, he had his testimony that he pleased God. How about our testimony? We have to have a testimony. Hallelujah. That, you know what? God saved me. I'm going forward. I used to be from the hood. Amen. I'm not from the hood no more. I'm going forward. I love God. Amen. I'm not a cholo. Hallelujah. I'm a man of God now. Amen. You got a testimony. You got to tell people your testimony. I was sniffing glue. I shut off sniffing glue. I didn't smoke no pot because I didn't like marijuana. That made me nervous, made me take the ambulance. All the time I took it, and that was only two times, I had to go in the ambulance to the hospital. And the homeboy said, whatever you do, don't give him no marijuana. Because he's going to go in the ambulance, and the cops are going to come. Huh? Your testimony, what's your testimony? Huh? I was messed up. I see the homies going by. Hey, you know what? Hey, I stop and pull over my car and talk to the little homie. The homegirl, I tell them about Jesus, and I give my testimony. And then they start crying, and they get saved. How many know that people get saved with your testimony? You got to testify about God. His testimony pleased God. Enoch's testimony, he pleased God. Are you pleasing to God? Do you please God? Don't you want to please God? When I wake up in the morning, I want to please God, but the devil's right there. Hallelujah. The demons are right there. Hallelujah. You wake up, you start your car. There he comes again. How many know you got to rebuke the devil? You got to say, devil, get out. I mean, that song they sing in the man, get on out. Hallelujah. Huh? I command you, Satan, to get on out. Huh? That's a powerful song. And we sing in the men's home and the women's home. I mean, that's a powerful song. Get on out. How many of you got to tell the devil to get on out? Our faith grows in God as we fellowship with him. Fellowship. We need a fellowship with the Lord. We must do both. The desires to please him diligently and to seek him. In other words, we care and want to do it. How many know we got to care about what we do? If you're an usher, if you're a preacher, if you're in the home, if you're in service for God, we got to care what we do. When people walk through them doors, they got to know, hey, we care. That's what diligence means. Hallelujah. That's what having a desire. Don't you have a desire to serve God in some capacity, wherever it might be? I'll tell you what, in the sound system, being up here singing, you got to want it. You got to want it bad. You want to please God, because Enoch pleased God. Number one, if you're taking notes, prayer. Prayer is important. Prayer, just talk to the Lord. Lord, I'm jacked up today. I'm messed up, man. Help me, Jesus. Help this. Help my mind. Help my heart. Help my walk today, God. I want to serve you. I want to please you. Prayer. Pray for people. Pray for the people on the prayer wall. Pray for the pastor, his wife, the family. Pray for the worship team. Pray for the men's home. There's things to pray for. And by the time you pray, it'll be 2 hours. Time goes by quick. The Bible says pray without stopping. Number two, meditation on the word. Meditate, meditate, meditate. You got to meditate. Meditate on one word, love. How many know that the love of God? The love of God is powerful. How many know that God loved you? How many know that we got to love the unlovable? Oh, man, I don't like that, brother. I don't like that. I don't like that, pastor. I don't like that, brother. I don't like that. I'll tell you what. It's not about liking. It's about love. Amen. Because love will cover a multitude of sin. That's what the Bible says. That love, hallelujah, I'll tell you what, it'll take you the extra mile. Hallelujah. Worship. Worship's important. We need to listen to worship music. Worship music. Hallelujah. Worship music in our homes. Amen. Worship music in the church. This worship team, when I go to bed or when I wake up, I'm singing these songs. Abba, I belong to you. Instead of singing la da 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 da, it's the one, no. know, I'd like the halftime show. Can somebody say Jesus?
Jesus!
Hallelujah. How many know worship is powerful? You ever worship God and then you start crying? And you're all by yourself and you're in your car or you're in your room or you're somewhere and you begin to worship God and the tears begin to fall and you say, why? Because of conviction, the presence of God, hallelujah, will touch you. The presence of God is powerful, amen, and the devil's a liar. Number four, discipline. 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 I remember when I was in the world, I had discipline. I didn't play no games. I didn't joke around and all that. I was a serious individual. And when I came into Christianity, the same way. I loved the Lord. How many know you love the Lord? I'm not saying not to have fun and not to laugh, but how many know you fall in love with God? And you discipline yourself. You don't say certain things. Amen. You don't tell certain things. You don't joke around and say dumb things. Can somebody say amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Discipline's important. That's why a prayer life, it doesn't matter if you read the Bible all day long, but how's your prayer life? How's your prayer life? Pastor Ruben taught me that. Prayer life, Rudy. Prayer life. Your prayer life. What's your prayer life like? How many hours you spend in time in prayer? Hallelujah. Prayer life. All of these help us in our walk with God. Psalms 119:10. Psalms 119:10. With my whole heart have I sought thee. Oh, let me not wander from thy commandments. Hallelujah. How many know that we could wander? We could wander from the word of God. We can fall away. That's why it's very important. The psalmist says, with my whole heart have I sought thee. King David was a powerful man of God. How about your heart? Do you seek the Lord? When things are happening in your life, do you seek the Lord? Or do we wander off? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Enoch walked with God in a wicked world before the flood came. He was able to keep his life pure. How many know there's a flood now? There's a flood now. There's an epidemic now. People don't want to come to church, but people will go to Walmart. They'll go to Disneyland. No masks, nothing. Hallelujah. But I'll tell you what, God is warning the world, and he's warning you, and he's warning the church. He said, wake up. I called you to be a watchman. I called you to be a watchwoman. Amen. To be watching out. Hallelujah. To spread my gospel. To tell people. You know what? We have so much gospel, but who are we giving it to? Where are you at tonight? Jeremiah 29:13. Jeremiah 29:13. And ye shall seek me and find me when you shall search me with your whole heart. Man, you got to do this with your whole heart. I don't know, but for Valentine's Day, I blessed my wife. I took her hand. When you're walking down the street, walking in the mall, you're proud of your wife or your husband. When you're walking down the street with God, You're proud to be a Christian. Hey, you know, yo soy cristiano. I'm a Christian. I love the Lord. Amen. You love the Lord? When I was from the neighborhood, I represented. My pastor told me, why don't you represent God like that? Thank you, Jesus. Let's do it. You see, God has a different plan for each and every one who trusts Him. So walk in faith. God has a plan for everybody. Everybody. You know what? God has a plan for me. I mean, you know what? God has something great for me. God has something great for you. Hallelujah. I tell you what, you got to trust God. Hallelujah. Don't trust anybody else, but trust God. Put all your faith in God. God will help you. God will see you through. He's not finished with you yet. The devil's a liar. He said you're going down, but you're going up. You're going up. You're going up. Hallelujah. Because God has called you. And I'll tell you, when God calls you, He does not put you back down. The anointing of God is in this place. The anointing of God. The presence. Oh God, give me your presence. I don't care about anything else, God, but show the people your glory. Show them how powerful you are, God, that you may get all the glory, all the honor, what you're doing in every individual life. Because you know everyone. You know every hair on their head. You call them by name. See, there's a song that God says that God knows your name. God knows your name. And God loves you. Continue to walk in faith in the power of the Lord Jesus Christ. Maybe you're here and perhaps you're not saved. You don't know Jesus. Or maybe you're a backslider. You were serving God at one time. You were on fire for God. But you wandered off. But I'll tell you what. God says, I want you back. God's calling you back home. God's saying, come back with me. And I will show you great and mighty things. You've never been saved. You don't know what it is to be saved. Well, I want to share a prayer with you. If you need Jesus, if you need Jesus to come in your heart and you're back, I want you to come to the altar. See, God always had an altar. And now He says, I want to call you publicly, publicly. I want you to come. If you need Jesus to come into your life, maybe you're not saved. Don't be embarrassed. Just come. Get out of your seat. Hallelujah. And come to the altar of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. The Lord is here. The presence of God, the anointing. Hallelujah. Anybody else? Anybody else? Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. And if you need prayer, you can come up. But you that came up, I want to say a prayer with you. If you will repeat after me. Dear Jesus, come into my heart. Forgive me of all my sins. Devil, you're a liar. Get out of my life. I renounce you in the name of Jesus. In the blood of Jesus, the precious blood of Jesus sets me free. Thank you, Jesus, for saving me. Now give the Lord a big clap offering, a shout of praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory, all heaven rejoices. All heaven rejoices over one sinner that comes to Christ. If you need prayer, you just come on up. We'll pray with you.
Thank you. Amen. We had an awesome service. Lives were touched. Hearts were changed. I'm telling you, God is on the move, church. And we're grateful for you plugging in and staying connected with us. We know what we have a lot of different avenues where you can watch us on. You can watch us on Facebook. You can subscribe to our YouTube channel. You can watch us on Instagram and allow God to minister you and keep you connected on what we're doing next and on what's taking place and what's going on here at Living Word. And so we're excited because we're seeing God move and we're seeing God just touch lives and God just doing miraculous things. And with your love and with your support and with you just allowing yourself to connect here, God wants to use you to make a difference and make a difference in your family, in your job, in your workplace. The message that God has spoken to you, the message that you've heard, is going to help you and build you to become that man of God and that woman of God you were called to be. Maybe you're saying, Pastor, well, I didn't have that chance to say that prayer. I was too embarrassed, or I was struggling to let go of some stuff, but I'm ready now. And so if you're ready now and you're ready to give your heart to God, I want you to say this simple prayer with me. Say, Jesus, forgive me of all my sins. Come into my heart and make me new. Thank you for forgiving me of all my sins. In Jesus' name, amen. That simple prayer has saved you, delivered you, set you free from your past, from the guilt, from the shame. And I'm telling you, now it's our job to stay plugged in, get involved, read your Bible, and stay away from the things of evil that get you caught up. I'm telling you, great futures ahead of you, great purpose are ahead of you, and we want to be part of that. Maybe you want to comment or leave us a message or send us a information. We want to help you on your journey, on your new journey with the Lord. And so we're grateful for you. We love you here at Living Word, and we are grateful for you guys. Also, we want you to know we have rehab centers for men and women, those who need help or those that are just tired and going through stuff, and maybe you need just a little bit more than that. Come to our centers. God will help you. God will do great things in you. Great men and women have come out of that. And I'm telling you, I came out of that center. God changed my life 28 years ago, and I haven't been the same. And we want to do the same for families and friends out there who don't know God and want to know who God is. So we're excited. Come connect with us. Know what's going on. See what's going on here at Living Word. We love you. God bless you. And remember, with God, all things are possible.
We were so blessed to have you join us today at Living Word Inland Empire. If you would like to hear more of today's message, head on over to our podcast and search Living Word IE. We want to thank you for joining us, and if you would like to watch more sermons, be sure to follow us on Facebook and YouTube. Again, thank you so much for joining us, and we can't wait to see you for our next service.